As the nation fights to curb the spread of this pandemic, the medical world is working on a short-term fix that could treat more than 34,000 people across the country who've already tested positive for the coronavirus. And they could be getting closer. Last night, a team of researchers released a report that detailed nearly 70 drugs that already exist and might actually be effective in treating the coronavirus. Meanwhile, the president is pushing an unproven coronavirus drug, and patients who probably don't need it yet are stocking up. Joining me now to discuss, Dr. William Haseltine, infectious disease expert and president of Access Health International. Doctor, thank you for joining me this morning. This report says it might be quicker to repurpose existing treatments rather than create a new one from scratch. Do these existing treatments actually work?
The existing treatments aren't known to work yet. That certainly would be the quickest way to do it, but they have to be tested. There are more than 25 drugs that already are approved of that 69 to 70 that you discussed for other indications. They may be effective. In addition to that, there are a number of other drugs that work against the virus directly, or chemicals, drug candidates that work against the virus directly, that are already known to affect the virus, but they haven't been fully tested in clinical trials yet. You've got to test these drugs in humans against the virus before you know what the answer will be.
Then how long do those clinical trials take?
We can accelerate those very dramatically. We can accelerate them so that once, if you have a drug that's approved, you can test it in somebody who's infected, and you can see very quickly by what's called a surrogate marker, that is just watching the level of virus in their blood drop. That's a marker that the virus, the drug is going to work. If you see that working, you don't even have to wait for them to get cured. You know that the virus, the drug is working, and you can begin to expand its use dramatically. So it can take, once you test it in people, it can be a very short time. I would say a matter of 1 or 2 weeks at the most, if the drug is already approved. If it isn't approved and it needs testing, I think it'll take probably till the summer. But I'm very optimistic that we're going to be able to tackle this virus with drugs. Drugs not only to treat those people, but an idea that I don't think most people think about, using drugs to prevent infection in the first place. That's what we do with malaria. You use drug, you take drugs if you're going into malaria zone. Drugs that are at work against the virus can be used for two purposes, treating those who are sick, and preventing those who are exposed from being infected.
So you agree with the president that using these anti-malaria drugs to treat coronavirus could be a somewhat of a golden ticket?
I don't necessarily agree with anti-malaria drugs. That remains to be seen. But I do agree that there are a number of chemicals that are in that are in clinical trials. Some of them have been approved for human use, which must be tested in humans infected with the virus before we know. The malaria may be premature. We don't know the answer to the anti-malaria drugs. We don't know yet. But the concept that I was trying to get at is using the drugs to prevent infection as well as to treat infection. And that's the context in which I raised malaria.
The president has mentioned several drugs out there, and what has happened, people have gone out and stocked up on them. And other people who currently need those drugs, like people who have autoimmune disorders like lupus, can't get them. How big of a risk is it when we talk about these drugs, when we say their names, that it can do more harm than good, that people who need them, they're no longer available?
It could do some harm because people who need the drugs need the drugs. And these are yet as unproven in human trials. All of us, I think, who study these viruses are optimistic that we will have these drugs.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.